Alhamdulillah that Allah bless us with this rain that have been going for several days, that we know the earth needs it. And we all need this rain. But let's reflect about this rain that's coming. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in one verse said, أعوذ بالله الرجيم وما ننزله إلا بقدر معلوم. We only let the rain come with the exact measurement that's known. That means the number of drops that's coming is being measured and known by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah planned it. And the way this rain coming, as Allah said in the Surah Al-Furqan, أعوذ بالله الرجيم وهو الذي أرسل الرياح بشرى بين يدي رحمته. Allah sent the wind at the beginning, give you the good news that the mercy of Allah is coming. Bushra, good news, bayna yaday rahmati, in front of the rahmat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in front of His hand, there's rahmat coming, bayna yaday rahmati. Wa anzalna min as-sama'i ma'an tahura. And then we brought from the heaven a water to make tahur, to make things clear. And then we make the city that is dead alive again. And that mercy, when it goes to the heart, this heart that is dead will be alive again. And then the physical rain, the same verse said, and then we let people drink from it, and the animals drink from it, and the people benefit from it. So, if we reflect on that, who's bringing this rain for us? And what's this rahmah that's coming for us? That's only Allah is capable of giving us this rain. And Allah said, in another verse said, أَفَرَأَيْتُمُ الْمَاءَ الَّذِي تَشْرَبُونَ. Did you reflect on the water that you're drinking? أَنْتُمْ أَنْزَلْتُوهُ مِنَ الْمُزْلِ أَمْ نَحْنُ الْمُزْلُونَ. Did you bring it from the clouds? Or I brought it for you? لو نشاء جعلناه أجاجا فلو تشكرون. If we would, we'll make it a water that you can't even drink. So thank me, have a hamd. Because Allah said in the Surah Al-Mulk, فَإِنْ قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُ مِنْ أَصْبَحَ مَاءُكُمْ غَوْرًا فَمِيَتِكُمْ إِمَامًا مَعِينَ. If Allah made your water is being gone from earth, there's no water at all. From where you get water? So you have to know that the good news that comes from the wind at the beginning, that rahmah is coming. And here's where I reflect on Rasulullah when the first thing will come, he will go out and let the water go to his body. And he will say, قَرِيبَةُ عَهْدٍ بِرَبِّي. It's a clause, just came from Allah. The one that I love, the one of the mercy, just came from him. And I want to increase the mercy that's coming from me. And subhanAllah, Rasul Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he described this ummah as this ummah of rahmah. The hadith said, فَعَنْ أَنَسِ بْنِ مَالِكَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ سَيْنَ أَنَسْ نَرَيْتِ الدَّاتِ رَسُولَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ قَالْ He said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, it's been narrated in Tirmidhi, that مَثَلُ أُمَّتِي مِثْلَ الْمَطَرِ لَا يُدْرَى أَوَّلْهُ خَيْرَ أَمْ آخِرُهُ. My ummah example is like this rain that's coming. You don't know where is the khayr. Is it at the beginning or the middle or the end? It's all khayr. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or Rasulullah s.a.w. described this ummah as the rain, that means even though he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that the best generation is my generation, the one after the one after, but at the same time, in every generation, there is khayr. Because Rasulullah s.a.w. said, you don't know, is it the khayr, is it at the beginning? أولي أم آخره. And definitely does indicate that this ummah is ummah of khayr. And Allah gives the example of this rain. So what we need to do actually to definitely enjoy the mercy.